बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। प्यारे बच्चों, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। आई वोंट टेक मच ऑफ योर टाइम, आई विल से ए फ्यू वर्ड्स। व्हेन आई एम अमंगस्ट टीन एजेस, यंग पीपल, आई फील वेरी मच कंफर्टेबल। I have passed through your age once and now I am 87. Don't say 37, I am 87. And I'm still active and I pray for others. I had experience, good and bad both, and I feel that children are my heart and soul. I love children because they are the future architects of the Muslim Ummah. I won't say not only Pakistan, I will say Muslim Ummah. You will have to come up to that standard, and I'm sure, I'm convinced that we can have a lot of hope in our youth. Qaid Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah was a great person. I met him once, and that was in 1946, before independence. I was in Bombay. I was a captain in the British Indian Army. Oh, he visited Bombay and he advised me, said, "Abbas, Hyderabad, Dakkan, used to be a place, even now it is there, Hyderabad, Dakkan, they were overrun by the Indian Army." He said, "They need army officers." I said, "Okay, sir." And I opted for Hyderabad, Dakkan. Then I opted for Pakistan. And the result was that I lost all my previous service. I started anew. Anyway, I'm glad because I am amongst you. I am in Pakistan. Pakistan is a great country with all potential if we work for the betterment of the poor people. I have been walking throughout the world. I have walked in Africa, Bangladesh. I have walked in India, Pakistan, and other places, particularly through the slum areas. I wanted to see the condition of Muslims all over the world. And I'm sorry to say that the majority of those who were in slum areas throughout the world, they were Muslims. They were Muslims. And surprisingly, they were being looked after by Christian missionaries, all white, some from France, England, all those places. They were being looked after by them. So I asked them, I said, "Is there any black like me, volunteer, or any Muslim?" They said, "No." Muslims were being looked after by Christians, and we Muslims were sleeping. Although, as you all know, the richest countries of the world are Muslim countries. How come the poorest community in the world is the Muslim community? How come? We'll have to think it over. And as I told you, that youth, you are my heart and soul. You are my heart and soul, and I can depend on you I can depend on you to have a new world order, where everybody will be equal. There, everybody will be equal. Even the poor will get 3 square meals a day. These days, Betty, I have seen small children roaming about with tears in their eyes. Why? They are hungry. They can't get 1 meal a day. And that is the world order. And again, I request my young lot, young people, please rise to the occasion and let us have new world order. Let us have new world order where everybody gets at least 1 square meal a day. May Allah bless you. I think I have taken a lot of your time, but I feel like speaking to the young lot. A young lot, I'm proud. I'm really proud. You are the future architects, not only of Pakistan, but of the whole Muslim order. We'll have to rise to the occasion, and I have lot of hope. I have lot of hope in you. May Allah bless you. Thank you.